Okay, Jeff, we just did an introduction to Dominion Theology, and we began to cover the basic belief that you and I were trained in, and much of the charismatic movement related to signs and wonders, or the heaven to earth message, the prophetic camp of Genesis 1, 26 through 28, where God gave Adam dominion in the garden to rule over his creation, and how that has been taken now by modern day signs and wonders charismatics and made to be a philosophical belief that with the cross of Jesus, that Jesus won back all the dominion that Adam lost in the garden, and how that plays out today in a governmental message that restored apostles and prophets back into the church, the kind of the message of the fivefold ministry has been brought into an everyday language, as it were, amongst charismatics, that the church has now been given authority to subdue the earth and to rule over the earth through church government. And so a lot of charismatics don't really understand how pervasive this is. They may be exposed to it, not knowing that it comes from a theological belief called dominion theology or kingdom now. And so we're trying to help educate, because we grew up in this and didn't see kind of the fallacy and how it was a departure from what the scriptures say the end days will be like, or how the church will operate in the last days, this sort of thing. So you have a few quotes there, Jeff, that we could start out with related to some of the primary people and voices, one being Bill Johnson. Okay. And some of the belief that's being preached today.
I just have one quote from Bill Johnson that talks about the spiritualized version or the spirituality of the kingdom now dominion concept. There are measures and levels of anointing that cause the reality of the scripture to change for us. A generation is forming now that will walk in an anointing that has never been known by mankind, including the original 12 disciples. This generation won't need natural illustrations to help them understand what their spiritual task is. They will move into spiritual territory that defies the natural order. God wants to give us revelations and experiences of heaven that have no earthly parallel. Jesus told Nicodemus, "If I have told you earthly things and you do not believe, how will you believe if I tell you heavenly things?" He longed to talk about things that his disciples were not ready to receive.
And so here Bill Johnson is saying, hey, we're coming into a time of kind of the greatest church that has ever existed. It will supersede even what the first century apostles experienced, that the greatest signs and wonders, the greatest demonstration of the rule of the kingdom of heaven on earth, which is church government through the earth, is happening in our day. And even the first century apostles that basically were able to, you know, touch the whole known world through the message of the cross, even though there was, you know, great martyrdom, great suffering, the church was just exponential in those days. And what's ironically missing in the early church message is the thought that the church would Christianize the world. Instead, they were very interested in making new disciples and birthing churches and preaching the message of the cross. Mm-hmm. So this whole theology about church government and apostolic government and apostolic prophetic government was not present in the early church that way. Instead, it was just the simplicity of apostles.
You know, Paul would have never referred to the day of the Lord if he thought the world was going to be Christianized or the world was going to be taken over, because there would have been no need for the day of the Lord. So when Paul refers to the day of the Lord, like in Thessalonians, it's a time of adjustment. It's a time of judgment. It's a time when Jesus Christ returns to the earth and adjusts the governments of the world, etc. He would never refer to that if the expectation was we are going to take over. He's going to be so pleased with us that he will come back and we will welcome him.
So in contrast to modern day philosophical, theological, kingdom now, dominion theology of a worldwide takeover, we see early Christians embracing suffering, the cross, martyrdom, realizing that there was a time coming, an age coming after this present evil age, mm-hmm. where through their self-denial and not denying Christ and going through incredible persecution, that there would be a coming reward or a right to rule with Christ in a coming age, ruling and reigning in the kingdom age. So there's a funny departure going on with dominion theology today amongst charismatics, and it's the absence of the notion of any kind of suffering. In fact, there's a real downplaying that's almost a defeatist-like level of Christianity. If you're going through suffering for Christ, you're suffering for righteousness, you're walking in a measure of aloneness because you're not following the world's trends, you know, that kind of preaching is put down amongst many dominionists. In fact, you know, we've been exposed also to the word of faith and the prosperity gospel and kind of the notions that dominionism also intersects with success, mm-hmm. as success standards according to the world. And so here in Scripture, we have a tremendous warning given by Jesus Christ himself mm-hmm. about the last church. Can you read that for us, Jeff?
Yeah, the church of Laodicea. So, I know your works, that you are neither cold nor hot. I would that you were cold or hot. So because you're lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew you out of my mouth. Because you say, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and know not that you are wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked, I counsel you to buy of me gold tried in the fire, that you may be rich, and white raiment, that you may be clothed, and that the shame of your nakedness does not appear, and anoint your eyes with eye salve, that you may see.
So, Jeff, we see a concept of possibly the last church of the age. Many think so. Certainly it existed even back in the times of the writing of the Apostle John, but maybe many think this may be a chronological order of church history, that the last church is wealthy according to world standards.
Exactly.
And there's an absence of suffering. There's an absence of trial and difficulty in with the Laodicean church. And they are wealthy in the natural sense. They're wealthy with the world's wisdom, with the world's goods. So they see this wealth as a sign of God's success.
Yeah.
And in dominion theology and ruling and taking over, there's a measurement system that seems to be put in there that if we are successful in the eyes of the world, or if we have success in numbers, or, you know, we're attaining wealth, that this is God's blessing. So this all kind of theology is flowing into a spiritual blindness.
Yeah.
Because what if you really are walking with the Lord and you really are in some measure of suffering and difficulty? Does that mean that you're not successful and you're failing God?
Now, there's no room in churches that follow an NAR dominionist doctrine for people that are sick or that people have issues, because obviously to them the blessing of the Lord is what's coming out of your mouth, that you're living blessed, that you're appear blessed. But I don't think there's anything starker than understanding being naked and having need of nothing. Thinking that, but in reality having nothing. And that's the whole concept of this elitist, puffed up, philosophical injection of foolishness that we have today. It is so against the tone of the Word of God. You look at the Apostle Paul, you look at the Scriptures that say that there's suffering. Glory comes after suffering. And it's totally against the whole tone of the Word of God. It really is.
So now we have this popularity message of dominion theology and some of the Word of Faith connection with that, and worldly success, and, you know, just trying to really draw the world's values into the church. Mm-hmm. So we see an absence of the cross, downplaying of the difficulty of trials and tests. And we have this other message of conquest and kingship and ruling and all those kind of things that would appeal to you in the sense of, yes, that's going to be very real, that those kinds of realities are coming with the return of the Lord and the kingdom age and the right to rule with Christ. But now we're trying to artificially put millennial conditions on the earth through dominion theology. And of course now we have a lot of emotion in with people with this situation, because we're talking about Bethel Church and Bill Johnson and Chris Valentin, kind of the primary voices of promoting the modern concept of dominion theology, which is this heaven to earth thing.
Yeah, we're touching God's anointed, etc. Right? Like I gotta read this. The promise to Laodicea: to him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am sat down with my Father in his throne. You know, I firmly believe that overcoming is overcoming the man-made, philosophical, elitist, propaganda, fantasy Christianity narrative that we hear today. It is so hard to go against the tide of this powerful wave that has hit the church. And how did Jesus overcome? He overcome through suffering. He overcome for going through affliction. And the glory he received was a glory he looked to. You can read in Hebrews. He looked away and unto. We're supposed to do the same thing. He was looking for the prize at the end, like Paul tells us to do it, and use him as an example. All of these things are not heard in the message today. And the overcomers are those that I believe return to Christ, return to the cross, understand suffering and the glory that will come and the age to come, that we are called to rewards and attainment in this life right now.
So we've seen the removal of the cross and the centrality of Jesus. We see the glorification of man and man-made wisdom that's come in the form of a package called Dominion Theology or Kingdom Now. Mm-hmm. We see one of the prevailing voices, and this is where a lot of emotion comes in popular teachers, and we're touching now Bethel Church, Bill Johnson. And when you begin to touch these names and people, they just so measure the charismatic Christian experience by we are rich. In other words, here's a teacher that teaches about healing. Mm-hmm. Here's a teacher that talks about signs and wonders and promotes the charismatic demonstration of the gifts of the Spirit and those sorts of things. So in strong emotion, charismatics measure a lot of their success by the gifts of the Spirit. You know, healings, miracles, signs, demonstrations, spiritual experiences, you know, encounters. That's all a measuring stick for spirituality mm-hmm. amongst the charismatics. So we have somebody that's speaking that language and doing a good job of speaking that this is our language. The sad part of that is it's a false theology. So we have this popular teacher, church, movement, and a language now that is being brought into a contemporary communication mm-hmm. or a model that says, hey, you know what? We live from heaven to earth. This is the reality of dominion theology, that we rule with Christ now, that the kingdom of heaven is now. We live out of our heavenly position to earth, and the demonstration of that is we host the presence of God. We host the kingdom of heaven on earth as a conquering church that has never existed before. This is our plot now, that the greatest Christians, the greatest church, the greatest conquering church that the world has ever seen is now in existence here because of the understanding of apostles and their position now carrying this kind of authority in government.
Right. And again, that feeds back to the whole reason I began doing videos, writing, etc., is we have a generation that has grown up under this, hearing this, that does not understand the other side, the truth of suffering, the truth of understanding sin and what it can do in our lives, and the opposite. And they actually fall away when things happen, when sin comes to their door, when death, when tragedy strikes, etc. And we're preparing a generation to fall away because we've injected this level of elitism and pride into a message, heaven to earth message, dominionist message, etc. So
can you imagine charismatics being so emotional about a natural worldly success that we applaud so heavily our healings and a demonstration of a miracle, a miraculous healing or a deliverance? We use that as our spiritual barometer, and then we got this horrible theology in place that says because these gifts of the spirits are of the Holy Spirit is happening, these demonstrations are manifestation of the Holy Spirit, that the kingdom of heaven is here now.
Right.
So we throw in a whole theology, and Bethel is one of the main promoters of it, in so much that they're being challenged through social media, Facebook, and other places, and being called on the carpet that this theology is not biblical theology. In fact, it's false doctrine. And in some cases, things associated with dominion theology, kingdom now, views towards God, like Bill Johnson has been challenged on his belief that the reason Jesus could do miracles was that he was not God as a man on earth during the incarnation. He laid aside his divinity and he was an anointed man at his baptism. Mm-hmm. So the miracles Jesus did, he did not do as God, according to Bill Johnson, because he laid aside his divine nature and functioned as an anointed man in right relationship with God. Well, that's flat out heresy. That's part of his dominion believing and teaching that what Jesus could do, we can do also. Therefore, with the proper apostolic government in place and prophets that will carry forth a super church of Christians, a Joel's army of Christians, a conquering church like the world has never seen, will carry this forth at the end of the age, the most glorious church that the world has ever seen to Christianize the nations.
Now, it's just a toned down, spiritualized, differently version of Manifest the Sons of God is what it really is. So this has all been around for quite some time. It's just been repackaged in new terminology.
And so if we call, you know, Jeff and I grew up in Dominion Theology. If we call this falsehood, false doctrine, or as we pointed out, even some heresies, there's such an emotional tag related to Bill Johnson as the voice that champions the success and the cause. Yes, we believe in signs and wonders, but they have to be biblical. They have to be biblical theology and support to them. And so we're getting further and further into levels of deception where heresies are even being introduced into dominion theology that undermines the person of Jesus Christ. And of course, we've been showing you how it undermines the cross. So we've got to bring this to the table. There is no teacher that is above any kind of scrutinizing, any kind of correction, examination. This includes Bethel Church, Bill Johnson, Chris Ballantyn, Jeff and I, or any other teacher. We are to test the spirits of our teachers and to see what manner of doctrines they're promoting. We have to do this. This is our responsibility. You've got to get away from the emotional success. Don't touch this because it looks and has the appearance of success, to really testing it according to the authority of scriptures. Okay. So we just wanted to take this time to also speak into Bethel's role as a primary voice in promoting dominion theology and some of the difficulty with Bill Johnson. Even though he's a popular teacher, we also have to speak the truth in love and bring this into an account, bring it above board, and start addressing these issues of false doctrine and even heresy. So thanks for your time and opportunity to listen. Hopefully this is going to be a great blessing and also a shout out of warning of people that have been inside of the movement and want to give expression that people can hear, hey, there's some things going on and they're not of God, they're not right. And we need to examine this truthfully and help one another in the Lord. Thank you, Jeff.